So our first step is going to be to surface this cupped and twisted board, make it flat. If you notice here, it's pretty cupped. When I flip that over this way, you can see it also has a twist in it, where these two corners are low and those two are high. So I'm going to hold it down on my waste board. And
for this part, I'm going to drill some countersunk holes in this 1x12 board, so that I can hold it directly to the wasteboard. I'm going to countersink these holes, that way the screw is plenty deep and my bit doesn't hit the screw head.
So I'm just going to open a new project and create this servicing toolpath here. Um, 30x18, just take a random size that's going to fit my toolpath here. I like to just make this fake material oversized.
I'm going to make a quick rectangle here that's a little bit larger than my board, so that my toolpath surfaces the entire board flat. And then I'll probably do that twice, one as a roughing pass and then one finishing to get a smoother surface on it. I'm going to set the Z0 using one of the lower corners and just do a skim pass from there. I'll probably have to do a second pass as well, just to make sure it's nice and even. And that's why our depth doesn't look like it's going to be that much, but it's actually going to take off a lot of material from that cup and the lifted, twisted corners. Your feed values are probably going to be different than mine because we have different machines. So just enter whatever values you would normally enter for your machine to cut a surfacing pass. So I just set the depth per pass to a higher number that we're going to do. So really this is going to control whatever our depth is per pass. So my next step is I can export this and run it in open builds, or I can just run it within here since it's a simple toolpath. Oh, I didn't set the bit size. So you're gonna wanna set your bit size here. This is 5/8 inch, so I can just type it in like that. Since this is the first of quite a few, at least a couple of passes, I can go higher on this. And the safety height doesn't need to be that large. Let me double check that position real quick before I send this car. All right, so we should be good there. Carve, confirm, it is secure. That is my bit size. I'm gonna turn the spindle on and run this surfacing pass. And dust collection would be nice. So I'm gonna go ahead and turn that on now too.
So now what I've done here is flipped it over, removed all the shims and spacers. This can go back in the box of tools. And then it's time to bring the spindle back over here. Zero it one more time. This time, notice the X and Y zero over here. After servicing this, I'm going to have to kind of line out my union so I can stain it. And then after we do that, we will head over to open builds for the rest. Fine like that.
I finished the first surfacing path on this side. I'm going to run one more, but I'm going to change the step over to about 20% and the step down to extremely fine. So I end up with very small ridges from the tooling marks, and then I'm just going to sand those off with a piece of like 180 grit sandpaper. And that's going to give me a nice smooth surface for staining and then carving the rest of it. So that pretty much summarizes how we take a warped, cupped, twisted board and make it flat and perfect for V-cutting on the top. In the next video, I will show how we get the flag imported and start cutting that one. Thanks for watching.